Good morning, everybody. We are live at the United States Fire Administration's Fire and Burn Laboratories here in Emmitsburg, Maryland. We're getting ready to do a live burn in this house right here. This is our complex burn house. The building measures about 15 feet wide by about 36 feet long. We've got it set up as the first floor of a row house or a townhouse, and we're burning this course for our R206, which is our Fire Investigation Essentials class. And so let's go inside and take a look at the setup before we start the fire. Okay, we'll take a couple of walkthrough, a couple of panorama shots here so you can see what's happening. So this is our kind of living room area, the entry area. It's furnished like a normal living room or den. We got a chaise here, oversized chair. We got some kids' toys, an extra couch, TV. You'll notice that the building is energized. So we have functioning electrical circuits, overhead lights. There's a fan running down here. So as our students then come back and look at this fire later on, they're able to use those electrical artifacts and that type of thing to help them determine where the fire started. And you'll see with a couple other setup things that we're using today, we've got a simulated stairwell here. I'm gonna open this. You can see there's no stairs in there, but there's a ramp that shoots up to an exterior vent on the roof of the building. Don't know if this is gonna come into play today or not. You guys may have to come up and take a class to find out if that's gonna be part of this scenario. We're gonna work our way very carefully, mind the camera person, because we do have cameras set up in here. We're taking four different interior video shots today of this fire. We're using a couple of single point of view cameras, and then we have two 360 degree cameras, which is something we've just started using, but it gives a very good overview of the development of the fire, the layer development in this room, and we've had pretty good results with it. If you'll pan over and notice, we've got some just some thermal couples attached to the wall. These are at 4 feet throughout the building. You may see them as we go through the rest of the building. So let's head down the hall towards the back of the building. All right, so in this area, this is a little short hallway. We've got a setup here with another chair, sofa, workstation. We've got a little ficus tree here. All of this equipment's energized so that it may create some artifacts our students can work with. We're gonna ease around the corner here and take a look at this one room we have off to the side. So this room right here, it's just a small space. So we can set it up as a closet or to simulate another room. In this case, we've got it set up to simulate a closed door of a bedroom. So don't know if you guys are familiar with that or not, but if you'll go over and visit our partners at UL, you can look at closeyourdoor.org or ulfirefightersafety.org. There'll be links down below. And it explains the importance of sleeping with your bedroom door closed. So we're gonna have this door closed. You can see we have a very lightweight combustible Halloween scarecrow decoration in there. And so we'll come back after the fire, shoot a couple of photos in there and see how this door was able to protect the occupant, our simulated occupant, see how things behave behind that door. The other thing we've got in this building, we've got some smoke alarms. There was one back in the front part of the building. We have one up here just on the other side of this light fixture. And we also have one back here in our simulated little small bedroom area. Now, we just had a time change to switch daylight savings time. So make sure that you check the batteries in your smoke alarm. And if they're changeable batteries, that you put fresh batteries in there. If you don't have a smoke alarm, check with your local fire department. They may be able to hook you up with one. While we're down here, we've got some other fuel packages in here. We have this iron, we have this plastic tub, we have a doorway here that actually goes outside, and then we have a doorway that goes outside into this room. If you guys will come on down, we'll look in this bedroom real quick. Okay. Now you probably can't tell because you're standing in the doorway, but in this room we don't have a doorway, so this is just an opening. So one of the things we want to try to simulate is we have a fire at that end of the building, We're going to try to show our students what happens at this end of the building, okay? So this door is going to be open. We're going to have a lot of flow coming around, and the fire is going to be flowing out this side of the building. But as you can see, we just got this set up, bed, a couple of posters on the wall, a chest of drawers. So we're going to come on out now. We're going to leave the building, and we'll get this fire started, and then we'll watch the development from the outside. Okay, so we'll just come over here. All right, so there's just a couple of last minute details that are being taken care of in the building. That door that we entered through, we're actually gonna cover that with a piece of sheetrock to protect that exterior door, try to give it a little more survivability. Our fire suppression today is being provided by Fort Dedrick. They're just down the road in Fredericksburg. They're a valued partner with us here at the NFA. They come up and support a lot of our fire suppression operations. So they're staffing up the RIP line. We've got a suppression line on the other end of the building. You will glimpse probably some ATF turnout gear here today. ATF, which is the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms. They are a federal partner that we have here on NFA. They have staff here at the NFA. And they participate in our Fire Investigation Essentials course, our electrical course. A lot of the programs that we have up here really benefit from the influence and the participation of ATF. So that gives our students access to fire protection engineers. We're supported by ATS Fire Protection Lab. They're chemists. We have CFIs that come in and lecture up here. So it's a great opportunity for local fire investigators to interact with ATF agents and learn from their experiences. If you want, so as we turn around in a minute and you see the fire start to develop, they're going to be coming out of the building. So those cameras that we were working with in there, they're down the hall, they're on cables, so they're going to be pulling those sleds out of the building as they come. So as the conditions deteriorate, they're going to come out, bring the cameras with them. So if you guys want to come down here a little further, then we can see if we start getting, I'm listening to see, I think I hear it. Okay, do you hear that beeping? So we have ignition in the building. We have a smoke alarm activation, at least one. We might have two smoke alarms activated at this point. So we'll start, as we start to get activity on the building, we'll turn around there and let you guys be able to see that. We've made a lot of improvements down here at the burn laboratory. If you haven't been to the NFA in a while, we've put in, this building is new that we're actually using today. We've made some changes to the ventilation and flashover demonstration. So those things are available for students as well. And in fact, today we have an electrical course running. It's RO255 if you're looking for it to register. But it's an electrical aspects class. They're down range working today in some new climate controlled classrooms that we have. And so they're available, you know, that's available for our students as well. All right, if you want to turn around, I think we're starting to get a little bit of, we're starting to get a little smoke showing out of this end open door. Okay, so while we're down here, you can start to just see some hot gases and smoke starting to vent out this open doorway. And you can hear those other smoke alarms activating. So what's happening in the building is the fire is developing, the smoke is rising to the ceiling, and then it's spreading out laterally, and it's developing a layer in the building. This open door, you can see, is a place where that smoke can spill out here outside of the building. Now, one thing you'll notice, this fire is going to increase in size. The fire grows exponentially. But one thing you'll notice is there were no and are no residential sprinklers in this building. We are doing that on purpose because we're trying to create a area, you know, more damage for our fire investigators, and we want this building to actually go to flashover and then burn post flashover. If there were residential sprinklers in this building, we would have a very small fire. At this point, the sprinklers probably would have activated and be controlling, or maybe should have even extinguished the fire by this point. But that'll just give you as a point of reference that this is an unsprinkled building. So you can tell that conditions are deteriorating. The down at the far end of the building, the windows are still in. If this door wasn't open, you might not even know there was a fire in this building if you were just walking past it. But you can see our smoke production is increasing, which means that the fire in the building is increasing. We're getting these off-gassing, the products of combustion are being released, and our controllers are bringing those cameras down the hallway at this point, and you'll see them come out of the building in just a minute. So you can tell the smoke production's increasing, the temperature's increasing inside the building. Here come our controllers with the cameras. So the conditions are deteriorating in there for them. They've captured all that video inside, so they're bringing those out. So we tether these camera sleds with cables so that we can come outside, but we can leave the camera in a little further. We can bring those out as we go. So we get we just leave those cameras in there for as long as possible to try to get as much of the fire development captured as possible. So again, you can see the conditions are deteriorating down here. As those controllers get out of the way, you may be able to see that we're establishing some inflow in this doorway. So there's some fresh air coming in at the bottom of the door. You see the smoke and heat being exhausted through the top. We may have to back up a little bit because we don't want to breathe this if the wind changes on us. So again, you can tell how this wind conditions today are affecting this fire. If we had an opening on the other end of the building, those gusts of wind that came in, that would perhaps increase the fire development, give it a little wind-aided fire spread. We're getting a little smoke. It's hard to see because we're all in the haze here, but we're getting a little smoke out of the other end of the building now. We're getting a little smoke, a little more heat buildup down there around those windows. And we're just gonna give this a little bit of time and watch this fire develop, let the fire develop a little bit as it goes. So as we're waiting for the fire to come out here to us, so this is our complex burn building. So what is gonna happen, we may have to back up a little bit more because we don't wanna breathe this. Come on back a little bit. All right, we've had to relocate a little bit. We're further back here behind engine 501. Wait for this wind to kind of kick up and let this smoke lift and get out of here, and then we'll come back up a little closer. All right, that was glass breaking, so we lost a window up there, probably on that far side of the building. So what I was saying before we had to back up. So this building is a complex burn. We'll use this building, I'll come around here. We'll use this building for at least three different groups of students. So when the students come in here for one of the investigation courses, we'll let them go through and look at this building. They can look at the fire scene, tell us where they think the fire started, talk about fire development, talk about fire growth. And then after the students have had their fire dynamics lecture as portion of the class, we come back down to this building and we go through the building again, this time with an instructor explaining the fire growth, the fire development, and really relating those factors of fire growth and development to the actual fire scene. waiting to see if they're going to open. So we have that other door that I showed you at the end of the hall. So we're kind of just waiting and watching this fire, giving it time to make its way down the hallway. We're expecting this end room to go to flashover. We want to transition from growth to the fully developed fire phase in that room. This doorway at the end of the hall, we're going to open or not open depending on how we, if we need more ventilation at this end of the building, then we are able to open that door. Right now the fire is developing. You hear a little bit of glass breaking. If you want to come back up a little bit further now that the wind shifted, you might be able to see we've got a little fire now venting out that far right window. I believe we lost both windows. So we're going to open this door now. We're going to open the door at the end of the hallway so that we provide more ventilation on this end of the building. So remember, a fire takes three things to burn: air, heat, and fuel, right? So I have a big hot mass of smoke and fuel at that end of the building, but I don't have much air at that end of the building. So as I open this door, we're going to let the fire come down the building, you know, come towards the ventilation basically. So I don't know if you guys can hear that. We've lost the smoke alarms now, so they're obviously been affected by the heat. They've collapsed, come off the building. Conditions at this end of the building continue to deteriorate, so we're going to about get smoked out here. We might have to move for you a little bit more. So we have some, while we're waiting on this fire to develop a little bit, we're about right ready to wrap up here. You can check the USFA NFA website for the Fire and Investigative Sciences courses. We have a Fire Investigation Essentials, an electrical course, a forensic evidence course, and a courtroom testimony and expert witness class. We partner with a lot of different agencies here at the NFA to provide this training to students. Obviously, we use Underwriters Laboratory stuff. Fort Dedrick is here. The International Association of Arson Investigators participates in our programs, and especially the courtroom training, and then ATF, like I said. So the students who come here get a really well-rounded, they're exposed to a lot of different instructors. You don't just hear one person talking all day long. You have many different instructors in the course. You notice now that we've lost that, I'm gonna walk around so I can see what's happening. Yeah, come on up. So you'll see things now are kind of stabilizing. We've got a lot of smoke and gas coming out of this end room where our controllers are. We have a little fire venting out this end door, and now we've transitioned to just the smoke coming out of those end windows. So this is what we're expecting. We're expecting these gases to start to light off down at this end of the building. And you can see our door, we're kind of getting fire progression out this exterior door. We're probably going to lose that door pretty quickly because they're just, it's a metal door, but it has polyurethane in the middle of it, so that burns. It doesn't hold up very well to heat. So you'll see that that starts to separate, and then once that happens, we kind of lose the integrity of the door. I don't know if you can see right below the controller there, but you're starting to get a glow in this bedroom. We're starting to get a little more fire involvement in there. You see that right there? Did you catch that? Perfect. Okay, so that's starting to light off. That's our transition from growth to fully developed. That's our flashover. So now what we're going to do is we're going to let this fire burn in this free burning, fully developed stage, and we're going to go ahead and create the damage there. So that's really what we're doing today. You guys saw it. We're not going to show you everything because you're going to have to come to class to figure out what happened. So thank you for joining in. If you like this, we would like to do it again. Like it, share it, a thumbs up it, appreciate it. And then don't forget, I will be at FDIC in a couple of weeks in Indianapolis. So stop by. We're at booth 8535. Stop in, say hey, let us know what you thought of this if we need to do other things. So thanks for watching. You guys have a great day. And we are done here at the National Fire Academy.